Good morning. Billy, please read the problem, and Bobby, please translate.
Flippin' physics.
A turntable is turning at 45 revolutions per minute. Angular velocity is 45 revolutions per minute, which we need to multiply by 1 minute over 60 seconds and 2 pi radians over 1 revolution to get 1.5 pi radians per second. Mints are located 0.030 meters, 0.080 meters, and 0.130 meters from the center of the record.
Radius 1 equals 0.030 meters, radius 2 equals 0.080 meters, and radius 3 equals 0.130 meters.
Determine what you can about the coefficient of static friction between the turntable and the mints.
The coefficient of static friction equals question mark.
Bo, please begin solving the problem.
Well, we need to start with free body diagrams, so let's pause the mint and add a side view. And actually, the free body diagram will be the same for all three mints, so we only need to draw one. The force normal is up, the force of gravity is down, and there has to be a force pulling the mints in toward the center of the record player, so that is the centripetal force.
Class, what are the three things I asked you to remember about the centripetal force?
It's not a new force.
It's never in a free body diagram.
Yeah. So, the centripetal force is never in a free body diagram, so that's not the inward force there.
And the in direction is positive, and the out direction is negative.
Correct. So, Bo, what force is acting inward on the mints to keep the mints moving in a circle?
Okay, that is the force the surface of the record causes on the mints, which is the force of static friction.
That is correct. Bo, please keep going.
Now we can sum the forces. Let's start with the net force in the y direction equals force normal minus force of gravity, which equals mass times acceleration in the y direction. The acceleration of the mints in the y direction equals zero, so the force normal equals the force of gravity, or mass times acceleration due to gravity.
We can put that in our equation holster, and then sum the forces in the x direction.
Actually, we need to sum the forces in the in direction, because the mints are moving in circles. So the net force in the in direction equals the force of static friction.
Which is positive in this particular example, because the force of static friction is always inward.
Which then equals mass times centripetal acceleration, but I don't know what to do now.
Force of static friction equals the coefficient of static friction times force normal, and centripetal acceleration equals radius times angular velocity squared.
And we can plug in from our equation holster, force normal equals mass times acceleration due to gravity. And then,
everybody brought mass to the party!
Yep. Everybody brought mass!
Billy, please finish the problem.
Oh, come on. I was almost done.
Okay, Bo. Go ahead.
We now know the static coefficient of friction equals radius times angular velocity squared, all divided by acceleration due to gravity. We can plug in the numbers for all three radii. The first one is 0.03 times 1.5 pi squared divided by 9.81, which is 0.067910, or 0.68 with two significant digits. The second one is 0.08 times 1.5 pi squared divided by 9.81, which is 0.18109 or 0.18. The third one is 0.13 times 1.5 pi squared divided by 9.81, which is 0.29428 or 0.29.
That does not really make sense to me. How could the coefficient of static friction be different for each mint? I mean, The surface of the record player does not change, so...
Bobby, that's a good point. So the coefficient of static friction between each mint and the turntable should be the same. And remember, the problem did not say determine the coefficient of static friction. It said determine what you can about the coefficient of static friction.
Does this have to do with the fact that we used the maximum force of static friction in our equations?
Right. The force of static friction is actually less than or equal to the coefficient of static friction times force normal.
Okay, so then the force of static friction acting on each mint is larger when the radius of the circle is larger.
So what we found is the minimum coefficient of static friction necessary to keep each mint on the turntable. And as the radius increases, it takes a larger coefficient of static friction to keep each mint on the turntable.
So then the answer is that the coefficient of static friction must be equal to or greater than the largest coefficient of static friction we got, because our mints always stayed on the turntable.
So our answer is that the coefficient of static friction is greater than or equal to 0.29.
Very good reasoning. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.